In this video, you're going to learn why carbohydrates are not the cause of diabetes. You're also going to learn the three most important nutritional factors when it comes to diabetes reversal, as well as non-nutritional ways to lower your blood sugar levels. Before we jump in, who am I? My name is Igor. I'm the author of the Amazon best-selling book called Type 2 Diabetes Reversal Secrets. As well, I run an online personal training company called Fitness Solutions Plus that specializes in helping type 2 diabetics reverse their diabetes. So let's jump in. The single most important nutritional factor when it comes to reversing your diabetes is not carbohydrates. It's not sugar. It's actually simple total calories. That's it. Just by normalizing your total calories, if you are an overweight diabetic, you can lower your HbA1c by as much as 4%. And that is the highest possible impact. See, carbohydrates aren't a problem unless they're excess carbohydrates, unless they're low fiber carbohydrates, which brings me to the second most important nutritional factor when it comes to diabetes reversal, which is fiber. Non-diabetics have lower fiber requirements compared to diabetics. Non-diabetics need approximately 14 grams of fiber per 1,000 calories. Diabetics, on the other hand, need between 17 and 20 grams of fiber per 1,000 calories. So if a diabetic is consuming 2,000 calories per day, they also need about 34 to 40 grams of fiber. If they're eating 3,000 calories per day, they need somewhere between 51 and 60 grams of fiber. So the fiber requirements of type 2 diabetics are just a lot higher. And by normalizing your fiber intake for your condition for type 2 diabetes, you have the potential to lower your HbA1c by as much as 2.5%, which is very significant and better than almost every medication out there. Now, what about carbohydrates? They're actually the third most impactful factor when it comes to reversing your type 2 diabetes. By having a low carbohydrate diet, you can lower your HbA1c, your blood sugar levels, by about 1.0%. So the difference between a high carbohydrate diet and a low carbohydrate diet of the same calories is only about 1%. So it still matters a lot. It's on par with the best medications out there, but it's not the most impactful factor. So why is it that carbohydrates often get blamed for diabetes? It's because of a number of different factors. Carbohydrates really are not the problem. The problem is twofold. Excess carbohydrates are the problem. When your carbohydrates, when you're eating too much of them, so much that it's going above your caloric limit or above your caloric budget, that's what causes the issues. And problem number two is not carbohydrates, it's low fiber carbohydrates. If you're having 300 grams of carbohydrates per day, but those 300 grams come from spaghetti, they're coming from white bread, they're coming from cereals and stuff like that, well, that's a very different 300 grams than if it's coming from beans, peas, lentils, wheat, amaranth, etc. So those are the real problems when it comes to carbohydrates. Again, carbohydrates in themselves are not the problem. Low fiber carbohydrates and excess carbohydrates are the problem. One factor that you're wondering, is he going to mention it, and I'm going to address it right now, is the glycemic index or the glycemic load. For those of you who don't know, the glycemic index is a measurement of the speed at which any given food raises blood sugar levels. The glycemic load is a measurement of the amount by which any given food raises blood sugar levels if you're consuming it in certain quantities. And so how much does glycemic load really matter? That's a real question. What we do know for sure is it's less than 1%. The research is very conflicting on it. Some research says it does affect blood sugar levels, but even when it does, it's less than 1%. And some research says it has no impact on blood sugar levels. And so does it really matter? I wouldn't really worry about it. What I would really worry about is total calories, which how do you figure out how many calories you should be eating? Well, you take your desired body weight in pounds and multiply that by 15. That's the first factor. The second factor I'd worry about the most is getting your optimal fiber. And I list the best fiber foods in other videos as well as in my book. And lastly, you can optimize your carbohydrate intake, because again, the difference between a high carb diet and a low carb diet of the same calories is only about 1%. And if you're wondering, I don't really want to lower my carbohydrates. I like my carbohydrates. Are there other things I can do to lower my blood sugar levels besides lowering my carbohydrates? And the answer is yes. There's plenty of things you can do that are not nutritional to lower your blood sugar levels. For instance, in my other videos, I talk about how helpful exercise is to lowering blood sugar. And I give you the specific exercise prescriptions for both cardio and strength training. Cardio by itself, done properly, has the potential to lower your A1C by about 1.0%. Strength training, done correctly and by itself, has the potential to lower your A1C by between 0.8 and 1.2%. Combined cardio and strength training, you have the potential to lower your A1C by about 1.2 to 1.5%. So better than carbohydrate restriction. So if you don't want to lower your carbohydrates, just exercise the right way. And again, what is the right way? I talk about in my other videos, linked in the description below. One other way to lower your blood sugar levels is through supplements. There's lots of supplements out there. Many of them claim to lower blood sugar levels, but only four do so by 1% or more. Two of those four, one is milk thistle. Milk thistle has the potential to lower your A1C by 1.40%. Another one is alpha-lipoic acid, which can be somewhere between 0.35 and 1.27%. And there are two other supplements that I talked about in my previous video on the four most effective supplements for blood sugar control. If you like this video, click like and subscribe. That will help you learn when I publish more videos about type 2 diabetes, and it will help other type 2 diabetics learn proper information about diabetes. Thank you and goodbye.